Above 70-year-old Hussein Aslan's bed is a wall decoration of the Al-Aqsa Mosque in Jerusalem. I made it out of my love for the original place, he recalls, my love for the Al-Aqsa Mosque, for the Dome of the Rock. He designed it 25 years ago, well before he lost his legs to diabetes, before he lost his sight, before President Trump declared the U.S. would recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, driving a sharp knife into an already festering wound for Palestinians. Three generations of the Aslan's family were born here. The Qalandia refugee camp started as a tent city. Over the decades, its reluctant residents built it up, adding on floors as families grew. Its densely packed population feel like they have just been left to fester as the state of Israel thrives. I don't cry about stones. I cry about the place, about the memories, Hussein tells us. The Aslans are originally from the picturesque city of Jaffa, right on the Mediterranean coast. It's a total contrast from where they are now. Manshia was its northernmost neighborhood, today a part of Tel Aviv. The most prominent building left of its Palestinian history is the mosque. Outside, we meet taxi driver Ahmed Al-Sha'ar.
His family's home was actually just down the street. The whole square here, that's now a parking lot, used to be lined with homes, and there was also a school.
He takes us into the mosque to see a handful of photographs, before and after.
This is approximately where we were just filming from, and you can see in this old photograph just how close the houses were to the shoreline.
In Ahmed's heart and in his mind, this is still Palestine, though he believes that they can coexist alongside Israel. I know from experience that some of them can be convinced that we have rights. We can live together, he explains. We can accept living together. We cannot accept that they replace us. It's a tempered view compared to that of others who live within the Palestinian territories, where the experiences are just too raw, like those within the Aslan household.
This is one of the last photos she has of her son.
Shahnaz Aslan wants to scream each time she remembers him. Her son was shot and killed on this building's rooftop in 2014, during a massive Israeli nighttime raid as they searched for three missing Israeli teens. All she wishes for the now four-year-old her son left behind is that he will have a chance his father never did, to get an education, and to live in a Palestine that isn't consumed by the anger that eats at their souls. They killed my cousin, our friends, one relative jumps in speaking of the Israelis. For me to go tomorrow and say hi to them as if nothing happened? Impossible. Impossible too for the population of Qalandia to give up on what they viscerally believe is their own land. The checkpoint here is one of the main ones into the West Bank, along the separation wall. Clashes like these and elsewhere throughout the Palestinian territories are growing in the aftermath of Trump's Jerusalem declaration. The pain of the Palestinians, defined differently for each generation, for each individual. For Hussein Aslan, now blind. But through his darkness, there is a repeating vision of the waves breaking on Jaffa's shore, of fishing, of the era we saw in the photographs. He imagines going to Jaffa, to his house that used to be on its shores. Arwa Damon, CNN, Qalandia refugee camp.